Hello dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is lesson number 12, food for all from standard 5th state board. In that we are going to discuss now the next point, that is what? Green revolution. Now what is meant by green revolution? So revolution means what? The change which are very good, or the good change which brings the different things, or which brings the different changes which helps to try the new things, okay? Or in short words, we can say that revolution means what? The good or the new things which are good for the progress. So today our country is self-reliant as far as production of food grains is concerned, okay? We are also able to export the surplus grain. The tremendous increase in food grain production in our country was achieved during the Green Revolution. So nowadays it is the 21st century and our country is the enough has done the progress, and now we are also able to send or to export the different grains or the grains in a more amount, and this is happens due to the Green Revolution. Now Green Revolution means what? There are the certain new techniques are there, because of that the production of the food grains increases, okay? It was brought about by the joint efforts of scientists, people working for the spread of the science, and the farmers. The credit for the research that led to improvement in the seeds of wheat and rice that result in Green Revolution in India goes to Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay, so this is not the only one person's achievement of the Green Revolution. This is the achievement for the different scientists which has done effortlessly work for the people of like the farmers, and also they try to maintain the spread of the science in the society. So this Green Revolution credit mainly goes for the one scientist, and his name was Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay, so the credit for the research that led to the improvement in the seeds and the wheat and rice that resulted in the Green Revolution. So this Green Revolution is basically improvement in the seeds of wheat and rice, and because of that improvement in the wheat and the rice, there are the more production of these plants, and that only called as what? Green Revolution. So in India, the credit of the Green Revolution goes to the Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Now we'll discuss the next point. Food security. Now what is meant by food security? Food is a basic need that we all know, but many countries have made laws to ensure that every person gets sufficient food according to their need. These laws are known as food security laws. In 2013, our country too enacted the food security law. It has made it possible to fight ills like malnutrition, starvation, and the death due to the hunger. Okay, so now we are enough growing the crops. We have the Green Revolution. Because of that, we are having a different variety of the seeds and the plants. Okay, but in our country still there are the certain category of seeds. Still there are the certain peoples are there, those who are not getting the enough food for a within a day also, okay? And that is the reason we have to protect the food, we have to take care of the food, that we have to think we will not waste the food. And for reason only there are the certain laws, and that law is known as food security law, which was invented in the 2013, okay? And what is the benefit of this? Because of this law, we are peoples are trying to secure the food, peoples are trying to waste the less amount of the food. Why? Because in one hand we are wasting the food, but on the other hand there are the certain people, those who are not getting the food, and because of that they are suffering from the malnutrition, starvation, and also the death due to hunger. Okay, next one, agriculture assistance program. Though this program, farmers are given proper information and guidance about the latest technology, irrigation facilities, improved seeds, use of fertilizers and the pesticides. So in this, what is the basic idea about this agriculture assistance programs? Through this program, the farmers are getting the new ideas regarding the new techniques, new information regarding irrigation, improved seeds and the use of the fertilizers and the pesticides. They can also get the weather forecast and the other agriculture related information for these assistance centers. So with the help of these assistance centers, also the farmers can getting the idea about the weather forecast and the agriculture related information. In addition, agriculture school have also been started for farmers. Members of farmers family can learn about the new technology as this school. Agriculture produce marketing committee hold exhibitions to for farmers. Okay, so these, in addition, for the better development of the farmers, there are the agriculture school. In that, the farmers can ask their queries, also their family members can learn the different things regarding to the agriculture activities. Also agriculture produce marketing committees hold exhibitions. So there are the certain agriculture based exhibitions are there, in that the farmers are getting the idea about a new technology. And the next one, the agriculture department of the government, agriculture universities, television, newspaper and the various periodical works for the spread of the modern methods of agriculture. Now it is possible for all farmers to use this modern method to increase the production. The whole country benefits these efforts. Okay, also in the additionally, there are the certain mass medias are there, like the television, newspapers are there. Also that agriculture university and the agriculture departments, government agriculture departments are there, which helps to which helps the farmer to get to know the different new techniques or to use it. Okay, so in this way, by using that different techniques, there are obviously there are the increase in the production, and nowadays the whole country taking the benefits of all these efforts. Now we'll discuss the last and the important point from the lesson, that is organic farming. Now what is meant by organic farming? Farming that relies on nature material is called organic farming. So the, as we know, in our previous video we have discussed about the fertilizers. Okay, there are the two types of the fertilizers, that are natural and the chemicals. So the natural fertilizers means only what? Organic farming. Farming that relies the on natural organic materials is called organic farming. It is form of traditional agriculture. In this method, the nutritive substance in the soil are retained. The organic pesticides used in the method have no harmful effects on those who eat the produce. Okay, so in the organic farming, basically they are using the natural fertilizers, also they are using the organic pesticide, which doesn't have any harmful effects on the last or the final yield. The grain grown by this method is nutritious and also good for the taste. That is why farmer have begun to appoint for the organic farming methods. Okay, and so these with the help of this organic farming, we are getting the yield, or we are getting the end product, that is the tasteless taste. Also they are having the very good taste also, and they are having the nutritious value also, and that is the reason nowadays farmers started to do the organic farming. Organic farming involves use of manure obtained from plants and the animals, that we have already discussed. That is only about natural fertilizers. So in the organic farming, we are using the natural fertilizers that we are calling as a manure, and that obtained from the plants and animals. This manure consists of the fish and the bone meal, animal excreta, as well as the decomposed remain of plants and animals. So these manure are made with the help of the fish and the bone meal, and also the excreta of the plants and animals, and also the dead parts of the plants and animals. Okay, so this is all about today. Here we have finished this lesson. So we here will stop, and we will meet in the next video. And for today, thank you.